Hi, welcome to the second lecture of Masterful AI. Mm-hmm. And in the first lecture, we learned how to draw the graph of the given functions. And with that, we will learn how to find the solution of a graph and solution of an equation. Of equations. Here, we have learned how to draw the many different type of the functions. The reason that we learned to draw the graph of a function is to find the solution of equations. An equation f of x is equal to 0 is a statement that asserts the equality of two expressions, so it becomes true or false depending on the value of the variable x. So equation curves in high school include polynomial equations and rational equations and trigonometric equations and exponential equations and logarithmic equations. Solving these equations is one of the most important problems in mathematics, as well as in AI study. We will briefly review how to plot a graph and find an approximate solution using a simple code. Let's solve the following problems. Find the solutions, find all solutions of the following equations. There are five equations, okay? Polynomials and first order polynomial. Polynomial with the square root and polynomial with the trigonometric functions and the log functions here. Now, we can solve equations using, say it is a solve command. And we could solve it by what? Integration by parts or by quadratic equations and solve the formula for the solutions. Here we introduce the solve command. Here we use two equal signs, equal and equal, for an equation. For example, solve this is equal to 0 with respect to x, okay, in any of the code here or here. If you copy this and practice it in here, like what you have here, and then most simple equation can be solved with that comment. This edge can also find solutions which is a complex number. But in order to do so, we need to have more knowledge on code. Or we can do the same thing if we are smart to convert the given equation into one or two simpler equations, which is equivalent that our AI can handle easily and fast. Okay, for this one, we have solved this by integration and by simplifying like this. So we know, the x is equal to 1 or 2 are solutions. X is equal to 1 and x is equal to 2 are all the solutions of this quadratic equations. And the same answer can be found by the solve command. Solve this is equal to 0 with respect to x. And we have a solution 1 and 2. This code solve may give us solutions including multiple roots or including imaginary numbers. For example, the second problem, the polynomial of degree, fourth degree polynomial, then we have how many polynomial? We have four solutions like this. Now we have four distinct solutions. Mm-hmm. For the next one, here, yeah, we can try to use the solve command simply, but it may not give us the solution that we like to have. In that case, we may just simplify this. Yeah. Isolate square root in one side, like this, move x to the right, then square this equation on both sides. Then we have x plus y is equal to 1 minus 2x plus x squared. In here, it is understood that square root of x plus 5, which is 1 minus 6, is bigger than 0. That's what we've learned when we were young. So, solve this with the same command that we have learned. Then we will have the answers. But since we have a square root in the equation, we know x cannot be bigger than 1 here. So we have two solutions like this, but x is equal to 4 does not satisfy this because the inside of square root should satisfy this, so x should be less than 1. So this is excluded, so we know x is equal to minus 1 is the only solution for the given equation like this. So if we can simplify, then we can use the same command to have several answers, but with the given condition, then you can exclude the unnecessary false solutions to have the right solutions only. And next, for this case, we can factor this as this. Then, solutions satisfies this or this. Mm-hmm. So we know sin x is equal to minus 1 gives us the solutions, and sin x is equal to 1/2 to give the solutions. So we solve these two solutions easily, then we can have all the solutions of the given equations with the simple command solve like this. We have two solutions like this. If you solve this, we can have this. But if you solve this, we will see the difference. Okay. See, if you draw the graph, this solution gives us what? Mm-hmm. This is a periodic equation. So we have the infinitely many solutions like this. Okay. Here for the second equation, sine x is equal to 1/2, this also gives us the solutions, two solutions with infinite many periodic solutions. So the when you use this simple command, the output that you have may not be all the solutions that you are looking for. So rather simplify the given condition and use this code is much smarter. Even though you don't have much knowledge on coding, like you as a freshman. Mm-hmm. Next, for this case, log function, you can simplify it as this. here, this can be simplified as this. Base 2, so 2 to this cube, which is a, and x times x plus 2 here. Then we can plot this graph. Mm-hmm. Then we know it has two solutions, here and here. That if we magnify, we know it is x is equal to minus 4 and 2. But this is a log function, so we know x is bigger than 0 and x plus is bigger than 0. So we said we know this one. So from this solution, x is equal to minus 4 does not satisfy this. So this one is the only solution that we have. So we simplify it and we draw the graph, then we can have the solution easily without any the confusion. Mm-hmm. Then we use the condition from the given equation, then we can exclude the false information, then we will have the only solution of the above equations, something like that. So that's the important part that we can use code when we use the computer to save the complexity and the time. The following example shows that for equations that cannot be easily solved by hand or with simple code, in that case, we can still find an approximate solution by drawing a graph and then use approximation skills on the graph. For example, assume that we have equations like this. You never learned how to find the solution of this. Mm-hmm. But sometimes in AI, we need to find the solution of this kind of the complex functions of composite functions. So find all the solution of this. How? Yeah. This equation is not easy to solve by hand. So. And let's try to use the solver, then output comes out like this. But you also have to compute all this to find the solutions. This looks like this. This is not what the solution that you need in AI. You need a number. Okay. So the existing code solver often simply gives an unfamiliar expression of solutions. Furthermore, many problems has no solutions, or our computer cannot handle it. In that case, the following method will be very effective. We can easily get more accurate approximate solutions by enlarging our graph. We have learned to draw the graph of this function. If we move the left side to the right, then you will have the function f of x like this. Then we can draw the graph of it. Then we will see where is the solution. Okay. We can then plot most of the logarithmic, exponential, and trigonometric functions. So we can plot the graph of y is equal to f of x. Then all we have to do is to find the value x where this graph meets this x-axis. So for this, we nudge the graph of a function within the proper range. So in this case, if we plot this on interval minus 2 to 2 first, then we will see it looks like this. Then easily we know it has two solutions here and there. If we magnify this part, then we will have the reasonably correct answers with the error sufficiently small, and here too. So let's try to find the solution in between 0 and 0.5, and another one in between 1 and 1.5. Okay. Because f of x is continuous, yeah, we can do so. So we give the interval 0.2 to 0.23 because it's in 2, it's in 1 and 3, so 2 and 2.3. Here, 1 and 1.5, so 1.6 and 1.1, so between 1 and 1.1 or 1.09 to 1.12, something like this. Then yeah, we can plot the graph from 0.2 to 0.23 here. Then yeah, we will have the graph like this. Here is the solution. The solution is 0.21567 8, almost 9. So we have 0.2219 is almost a solution. Mm-hmm. And the next one is on this interval. Actually, if we can find the solution in this way, if we exact find the root command on this, give us the numerical solution. Actually, this command was produced with this technique. So now you can use the find root command to find exact solution with the error as is required. The second one, if you draw the graph from 1 to 1.5, then we have find root command give us 1.084 as the solution. So now we have two solutions, roughly. One is 0.22 and the other one is 1.08. If we want to have a more accurate one, then we can add one more comment here to expand the digit. Okay, anyway, so these ideas lead us to build this find root code that gives us the approximated solutions to be given to us. So with this method we now can plot a graph of most of the function that we learned and zooming in and out of it, and then we can easily find the approximated solutions for most of the equations that we need to solve. It is kind of the key idea of this section. Here is the open problem that you're supposed to do and to share in Q&A. And here, find approximated solutions to various equations from other textbooks that you have used so far. Then, yeah, you will be able to handle the most of the equations that you had some difficulty for some complicated expressions. And yeah, these are the kind of PBL report that you can refer later. You can practice those codes in this web address. The first homework of the first week will be this. After solving the above open questions, please share a brief self-introduction and motivation for taking this course, and the summary and practice or equation or answers and anything that of your academic activities in the first week on the Q&A board of our iCampus. I think that's the end of the first lecture. Any questions? Then ask it in Q&A. Okay. Good job.